Hi, and welcome to a new episode of Product Release Notes, where we present the latest updates and improvements in Omega 365.
Yes, that's right. And in today's episode, we'll be presenting fresh updates within access management, documents, workflows, meetings, lessons learned, and complete. And let's have a look at access management first. So what we've done now when it comes to activities is that these are controlled by who has access to the activity group. So in activity groups, you can grant access to the roles here. Same concept as we use on the documents. There you also provide access to document groups. And another thing is that we've added a new module, a new system module, so to split better who can update the person's info and who can grant access. So we have this award roles that you need to have access to be able to award roles to a person. That doesn't give you permissions to update the person's person information, but you can grant the roles. And then if we have a look here now in persons there, if you have DB security admin and SQL Server security admin, you have the possibility to reset a user's password. I don't have it, so I don't see that button here actually.
And as long as it's a static user, it's not an Azure AD or Microsoft 365 user account, or it's only for the internal.
Okay, and if we move to documents, we have the possibility in shared folders to move a document into the document register. And what we added now is the possibility to add an existing document that you have in the shared folders as a new revision to an existing document, or as a native file to an existing document, or as an attachment. Because sometimes that could be that you have planned documents in document register, so there you have overview of all the documents that you want to produce, and then some work with some of these documents in this shared folders area, sharing it with the external party, for example, or someone else internally. And then when it's ready, push it over to the document register. And then if it's a new revision of a document that has already been defined in the document register, you can use this one, a native file. Or it can be a completely new document as well. And another thing in the document register is that you have the possibility to include obsolete documents in this register. That means that also previous revisions appears. Those are a little bit clearer marked now. So if I go in here, a little refresh, and you will see when I have included obsolete that there is a slight gray background on those that are obsolete. In addition, it's strike true. And if I try to download these documents, I will be, of course, allowed to do that, but I will get another check, or another warning, I mean, if you really want to download these, as it includes obsolete documents. But you, if you choose yes, of course, then it proceeds. In workflows, there we've added the filtering possibilities on properties. Properties is nice to have when you have if you can't use the existing attributes that are defined on the workflow register, because those are defined by the product
itself.
But the properties you can add yourself, and to be able to search among those, you go to the properties field, and then it all the different property values will be shown here in the properties column. So you can filter for those the same way as other columns then. And in meetings, those that has been utilized the meeting register are familiar with the concept that on the right hand side of the agenda item you can get information like the workflow itself, the risk register, progress curves, everything that is available as URLs can be added here. Very practical. And sometimes it's very practical to be able to blow this up in full screen. Click on that X to get it down again, and this one to expand it. Lessons learned. A new thing we've had there is that on an incident now, you can add related lesson learned by clicking here. And another thing is that in the lesson learned itself, you have the possibility to publish a lesson learned to org units. The new thing is that you can choose exclude sub org units. That means that you might have a lesson learned that you want to publish to the project, but perhaps this lesson learned, it's not something that you want to expose to your contractors.
Yep.
In Complete, we have a new feature in the Object Explorer. You can search in the Explorer. So like in this case, search for room, and it will be clearly marked. So it searches among all the items in the hierarchy here.
Yep.
And then also when it comes to signing, we showed in last episode that you have the possibility to remove signatures so that you can do any updates to that check to that activity.
Mm-hmm.
And then they have to re-sign it since you have been doing some updates. At that time, it was not possible to do that on closed activities. We do now support that as well. So I have the possibility under setup commands to reset signatures.
Okay. Yep.
So if you don't need to do some changes, do the changes, and since you alter it,
you need a new signature.
Yep. Yes. Yes, that was the most important update from this release.
Yeah. Thank you, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.